Welcome to Painting with Steve. Today we'll be continuing painting the Mansions of Madness miniatures. Remembering last time we put on the first base color to our miniatures, and today we're going to be putting on that second color. So let's get painting. First thing I need to do is figure out what my secondary color is going to be for each of my miniatures, and then we will apply it to them. One thing that's a little bit different from what we did before when we painted the first color is that we're using a much smaller brush, as you can tell. In this case, we actually do care about staying within the lines because the more we can, the less we have to repaint later on. On the other hand, if you do miss and do get outside where you want to put your second color in, don't worry about it. You always can go back after it dries and paint it over with your base color. In this case, I'm picking a turquoise blue to go along on our basilisk here, showing basically his underbelly and scales giving a little bit of a contrast. I didn't want to make it too much of a different of a contrast color by, say, using like a orange or a yellow, but I did want another different shade of blue, which I think is looking pretty good. So let's finish up our basilisk, and then we'll move on to our temple guardians. I'm glad I got a smaller brush here for the basilisk because his coils, since they're all kind of twisted together, getting to some of his underbelly is kind of tricky and takes a little bit of patience. And as I mentioned before, if you do happen to miss, which you will inevitably, just go back over it. But I think he's looking pretty good. So let's see what we're going to do with the temple guardians. As always, when you switch between colors, make sure you thoroughly wash out your brush and I'll wipe it dry with a paper towel. The guardians don't have much more different colors on them other than they're gray, because they're pretty much made of a giant stone column. But they are carrying some sort of chain-like device in their right hand here, so we're going to paint that chain using a very bright silver, which I think will look pretty good. So let's get going on it. When painting small details like this, the key is to just take your time. Make sure you got good support on your hand so you make a nice level stroke, and make sure you have enough paint on your brush. Believe it or not, it's harder to get exactly where you want to be when you have hardly any paint on your brush. It actually will flow better off if you've got a decent amount. With time and practice, you'll just get the hang of making sure you have just the right amount of paint on your paintbrush. I'm liking how this is coming out. It's really going to make that pop, as you can see. So let's get the other guardian done, and then we'll move on to our feathered serpent. This always seems to happen to me. Just as I get my paintbrush cleaned up, I notice that I missed a spot for that color. In this case, I forgot to do the underside of the chain. So just put some more paint back on it again and double check the other miniature, because if you miss it in one spot, odds are you probably missed it in the second one as well. So there, let's go clean our brush a second time and then we'll move on to the serpents. And we're with the serpents here, we're going to be start working on their wings. And we're adding a kind of a bright orange or red. Actually, I think I'm using scarlet here as the color, which is kind of an orange red. And we're going to be doing that, creating a layered effect for our winged serpents. So let's get going on it. When painting features on a miniature like feathers, I find sometimes the best way is to kind of go along the grain of how the feathers are going. Also, if you're painting a certain area, I find get the edges done and then you can just paint the middle in along with your at your leisure. The key is to get carefully to the edge from one color to the other, and sometimes it's not so much of a stroke as it almost is like a dab or a poke that gets you a more accurate right up to the line that you need to get. The key is you definitely also, just like with your primary color, you want to make sure you're getting full color coverage of your second color here. And there, our guy is looking pretty good. You see, he's starting to get some distinction to him. So let's get the other winged serpent done, and then we'll move on to our serpent people. Like before, you may have to do some touch-up. You'll notice some spots on your miniature that you might have missed. In this case, it's the top edges of the wings, because when I paint wings, I paint one side and the other side, and sometimes you miss out on the top. So let's get our brush cleaned up, and as I'm cleaning it up, I notice there was some gray from the primary color missing on this Stone Guardian. So quick touch-up on him. And now let's get moving on to our serpent people. After I make sure him, I may miss the same spot on both of them. That's one thing when you do several miniatures the same together. If you're going to miss something, you're going to miss it on all of them. For the serpent people, I think we're going to be working on a yellowish color. So first I think I need to get some nice blue. I think we're going to actually paint the bottom parts of the serpent people as well, though I could be wrong on that. So let's see what we're doing here. Nope, we're putting some yellow on him. We're working on basically around the head of him, because the serpent people, their heads are really almost like a cobra look with their hood on either side, and I thought to make that stand out a little bit, I would paint it in a more of a good accent color of this kind of neon green color, which I think will make it pop a little bit better. So let's see how that's looking. Yeah, I think it's looking pretty good. Making sure careful that you don't get it too much onto the face of the miniature, because I want to keep that. And see, it's looking pretty good. So let's get the other two done, and then we'll see how our miniatures are looking. We'll be right back. last of the serpent warriors here. And one thing I do find when you do several miniatures of the same type, the last one you do will always go faster than the first one, because you kind of get this pattern and kind of learn the miniature and what works and what doesn't work. So let's get this one finished up, and then we'll take a look to see how our miniatures are looking. As I mentioned before, you can always go back over your miniature to cover up any mistakes you might have made with a secondary paint color. In this case, I'm touching up my basilisk because I missed a little bit. And it's always good to do that after you get done all your painting, because then the other paint is fully dried. But yeah, I went outside the lines a little bit here, and this is just neaten up the miniature just a tiny bit. So there, our miniatures are done for today. Let's take a look. They're really starting to come together now. Oh yeah, I like that secondary color on the basilisk. That silver is definitely a good on the Temple Guardians. And I really like the orange or reddish color on our feathered serpents. But that's all for now. Next week we will continue with some more, adding more color details to our miniatures. But as for now, happy painting! Thank you.